Hey guys, welcome back. So we're going to be doing a March to October series for as many teams as I can throughout MLB The Show 20. So you got your favorites, contenders, underdogs, long shots. Obviously, you can probably understand what each means. Favorites, obviously, your top teams to win the World Series. Contenders, they have a good chance at maybe making it and possibly winning it. And the underdogs who might not be as heavily favored, but have teams good enough that if they get hot at the right time, they can win it. And long shots, obviously, teams that have horrible records last year and not very good rosters who most likely won't even make the playoffs or finish above fourth in their division. But obviously, I'm a Brewers fan, so we're going to be doing ours with the Milwaukee Brewers, who are considered underdogs this year. I personally think that they could win the division. I think the NL Central is wide open. I think it's going to be between the Cubs, Cardinals, Brewers, and Reds. Pirates are like the only team that really aren't in it, in my opinion. So let's watch the little video here. I know they have that at the start, so we're going to be doing it on All-Star as well. So, all right, begin to March to October. Let's watch this video real quick of the Brewers.
Entering 2020, the Brewers may need a few extra name tags in the clubhouse. Despite back-to-back postseason appearances, Milwaukee turned over the bulk of its roster. It was a bold move. But any team that can lean on Christian Yelich and Josh Hader to anchor its lineup and bullpen is off to a good start. Craig Counsell's teams have shown a knack for outperforming expectations, and the Brewers believe they have what it takes to make it three in a row for the first time in franchise history.
All right, there you go. Pretty dope video there from the MLB The Show Milwaukee Brewers March to October hype. So I think what we do here, you start out on opening day in the sixth inning, and your goal is to win opening day. And then if you win opening day, you get your momentum to earn wins in the future. So we're going to be starting out in the sixth, I think. We'll see what the score is. We're going to skip through this because obviously we know what we have to do. All right, so as in most March to October episodes, today's action will begin in the mid-late innings. You are now taking control in the top of the sixth. All right, here we go. Let's do it, boys. And girls, whoever's watching. All right. Oh, we're winning 2-0. That makes things a little easier. All right, we got Woody still on the mound. He's got 70 pitches. There we go. March to October has officially begun. So let me know down below who you guys think is going to win the NL Central this year. Like I said, it's pretty wide open in my opinion. I think it's one of the most parity-filled divisions in baseball. Do you guys think the Reds are overhyped right now? Do you think that they're, as Yu Darvish flies out to Lorenzo Cain in center field? So yeah, let me know who you guys think is going to win the Central. Do you think any other teams are going to make it to the playoffs, like as a wild card or anything like that? Chris Bryant, first pitch fly out to left field for Ryan Braun, flying through the sixth inning here. Also, let me know if you think excuse me, lost my train of thought, and that's going to be another flyout out to Ryan Braun. I think what I was going to say is let me know who you think is going to have a breakout year in the NL Central. Do you think that Keston Hira is going to have a better year than his rookie season? Do you think that Jason Kipnis is going to have a little bit of a bounce back season with the Cubs? Do you think Josh Bell is going to have another MVP caliber season? Is Moustakas and Castellanos going to continue their good hitting skills and get good numbers again? Just let me know what you think down below. I'm curious to hear what you guys have to say. And he's going to line out to Baez to end the bottom of the sixth. We go to the top of the seventh, still up 2-0. Ooh, Schwarber gets a hold of that one. That's going to be a one-out double for Kyle Schwarber here. He's going to have a man in scoring position with one out here in the seventh. What the heck? I thought he stopped the second. That's weird. All right, he's going to get a triple out of it. I honestly wasn't paying attention there, so that was bad defense on my part. See if we can get him chasing. Get that brawny. What the heck, dude? Are you kidding me? I overran it. What the? I have no idea what's going on here. I tried throw canceling. I don't know why he left. So they tie the game up. What the heck? Are you freaking kidding me? There's no way that should have been a base. Oh, come on, Blue. base hits, but then there are... You kidding me right now? How did that not... Good Lord. Now that was bad defense there. Oh, come on now. This is just getting ridiculous. Shouldn't have even been a tie game. Or, jeez, 3 runs, 7th inning. Gonna have to come back in this one, but we really shouldn't have to. Holy crap. This is horrible. Well, we finally strike Yu Darvish out to end the 7th, but not before they get 3 runs on about 3 errors. Now we got to come back in this one, see if we can tie it up. Javier Baez is going to fly out to right field to Yelich, so we got a 3-up, 3-down 8th for Woodruff. That's going to wrap it up for him. Let's see if we can win the game for him. Get through. There we go. That might be a double. I'm not going to push it. Ben Gamel gets a leadoff single. We got Eric Sogard coming up now. Man on first. Nobody out. Are you kidding me? Jericho grounds into a double play. It's 2 outs now. Lorenzo Cain's up. Alright. Oh, God. Kesson here can't make the play, so he's going to have a man on first, 2 out. Alright, we're going to get the ground ball out to second. We go to the bottom of the ninth, still down one. Hopefully we can at least tie it and then maybe walk it off. He's going to bring in Craig Kimbrel to face Christian Yelich. Come on, Christian, be the MVP. I need you to be. Alright, that's going to be a base hit at least. So we got our leadoff man on with nobody out. I don't think I'm going to steal unless it's like the third pitch in the at-bat. We got Ryan Braun up at the dish, or Kesson here, excuse me, with nobody out. You freaking kidding me? That was a horrible jump. I don't even know why I didn't attempt to try and swing at that. Just doesn't feel like our day. Swinging at a changeup in the dirt. Come on now. Refocus. Fouling off a fastball. I can get to Justin Smoke, that'd be nice. I don't do that bad with Smoke. I like his swing. Kesson here is going to fly out to right field, so now we got Ryan Braun up with 2 outs. It doesn't look good, boys. I think I might have choked this one. He did. Drop for me. There we go. Alright, so Brawny's on with Justin Smoke up. Let's see if Smoke can drive one. I'm going to probably pinch hit for Braun here. Or, yeah, pinch run for Braun for Garcia. So that way, if it's in the gap, he's got a good shot at scoring here. Come on, Smoke, drive one in the gap for me one time. Go! It's over his head. Alright, that's not going to score him from first, unfortunately, but we got the tying run on third with 2 out. Gosh, that was crushed. Who do we got now? Omar Navarez. All right, come on now, Omar. I'm going to get a lead at third, just in case on a pass ball. Way to back on it. Get through. Let's go. Tie game. Down to our final strike. We get 3 straight hits. Let's go. Tie game. Winning run on second. Let's drive him in. It's... Ah, that was hit well. Just missed it on the PCI. So we come back and we tie it in the bottom of the ninth. It's 3-3. Let's try and hold him here. Waited on it. That's going to get off the wall. Lorenzo Cain's going to get a 2-out double here with Christian Yelich coming up to the plate. Base hit's going to score Cain from second easily. We just got to get it into the outfield for him. Come on, Yelich, walk it off for us. Christian Yelich, NL MVP. The pitch. Ball high. 1-0. Strikes. 2-0. I'm surprised they're even pitching to Yelich. Waited on it. It's hit well. Are you kidding me? Good, good contact. That doesn't leave the yard. We go to the top of the 11th. Make the play, Jericho. Good strong throw. Suter retires the Cubs in order 1-2-3. We go to the bottom of the 11th with Hira, Garcia, and then Smoke due up. Let's try and walk it off. Oh! I missed it. That was it. That was the pitch. Ah, that hurts. That hurt a lot. Gone. Justin Smoke walks it off. Perfect, perfect. And we're going to start the season 1-0. Justin Smoke walk-off hero in game one of 162. Man, that wasn't the prettiest game at all by any means defensively for me, but a win is a win. Brew Crew walk it off against the Cubs in the 11th inning. Man, what a shot by Justin Smoke. That's a pretty good end to the first episode of this series. We'll give you the second moment sometime in the next couple days or so. But the Brew Crew win game one of game one of the 162 season. March to October, great start here. Justin Smoke, you see the replay, weighted back on it perfectly. No doubt about it. Ooh. So there we go. Josh Hader, or Brent Suter, excuse me, gets the win. Bullpen locks it down after we screwed up some defensive. We screwed up defensively in the seventh. So there we go. We'll see you next time for, excuse me, for March to October episode 2. See you later, guys.